Good afternoon. Your Excellency Roni Araiji, the Lebanese Minister of Culture, Dr. Zahida Darwish, the Secretary General of the Lebanese National Commission for UNESCO, AUB Provost, Professor Muhammad Harajli, Dean Patrick McGreevy, colleagues, staff, guests, and students. It is my privilege to welcome you all to the 4th International Organic Chemistry Competition, OC4. The Education Life section of the New York Times reflected on organic chemistry and the sheer terror this beautiful subject exerts as a requisite for part of the student body, predominantly called pre-meds. The article, Chemistry for Non-Dummies, credits organic chemistry in 2009 as one of the hardest, and rumor has it that its sole purpose is to weed out pre-meds. For my organic chemistry courses at AUB, this perceived dread of organic chemistry underwent a metamorphosis, a caterpillar to butterfly, or alkene to epoxide, carboxylic acid to acyl chloride. The emergence of clickers at the American University of Beirut and Lebanon on January 22, 2009, started to reveal the beauty of organic chemistry. Organic chemistry can be enjoyed if the correct tools are at hand and learning steps into the limelight, while teaching takes a large step towards the back. A true reflection of this ultimate transformation is seen in this room, where 246 students are taking the time to prepare, participate, and measure their skills to win the prize of being the kings, queens of organic chemistry. I'm very grateful to Professor Ellen Tratras Contis, the chair of the International Activities Committee of the American Chemical Society, and to Professor Allison A. Campbell, the president-elect of the American Chemical Society, for endorsing OC4 and for sending the video remarks that we just witnessed. We held the first organic chemistry competition on February 7, 2011 to celebrate the International Year of Chemistry, IYC 2011. 42 teams, two participants per team, from six universities from Lebanon participated in the 2011's competition. In 2012, we held the second edition of the competition, where 62 teams from 11 universities from Lebanon, Turkey, Sultanate Oman, Iran, and the United Arab Emirates participated. The third edition witnessed the participation of 84 teams from 11 universities from Lebanon, Egypt, Turkey, and the United Arab Emirates. Today, and on the occasion of the AUB's 150th anniversary, the Organic Chemistry Competition is celebrating the presence of 123 teams from 10 universities across Lebanon. I don't think any other event has witnessed 10 universities from Lebanon in the same place. The American University of Beirut, the Lebanese American University, the Lebanese University, St. Joseph University, the Beirut Arab University, the University of Balamand, the Notre Dame University, the American University of Science and Technology, AUST, the Holy Spirit University of Keslik, USAC, and the Lebanese International University. And we have participants from seven universities from across the world. The Novosibirsk State University from Russia, the University of Novi Sad from Serbia, the Sofia University from Bulgaria, the Middle East Technical University from Turkey, the Razi University from Iran, the University of Jordan, and the Jordan University of Science and Technology from Jordan. I kindly ask all the contestants to stand up. Ladies and gentlemen, the students before you come from 17 different universities across seven countries. They have different backgrounds, but they speak the same language, the language of organic chemistry. I hope you will enjoy the competition. Please be seated. I call to the podium Victoria Ahmed, the president of the Organic Chemistry Club that took the lead in organizing today's event, to say a few words. Victoria.
Esteemed guests, the Organic Chemistry Club is ecstatic to welcome you today to our fourth International Organic Chemistry Competition, OC4. On January 28, 2014, I first witnessed the organic competition spirit as a volunteer. There was a spark about the competition and the club that compelled me to join, but back then, I couldn't place my hand on what drew me to the club. However, this spark kept pulling me back with no awareness of what it is. In June 2015, the OC4 team started working for the next big event, the fourth International Organic Chemistry Competition, OC4. The Organic Chemistry Club and the OC4 team have been working hard ever since in order to raise funds, recruit participants, film reports, and many more. While working on the competition, specifically fundraising, a very simple phrase caught my attention. The organic competition is an event made by students for the students. This sentence, however, is what makes the OC4 unique among many other educational events. In every step we took as a team, this sentence has been guiding us over and over again. We considered every option deeply, making a decision in the interest of students worldwide. The amount of work and effort put into making OC4 an unforgettable event by the OC4 team for the students is truly inspiring. Actually, I now realize what has compelled me to the Organic Chemistry Club and the OC4. It was something I have thought only little of still exists. The soul of the competition is embedded in the kindness the members place into it. I have never witnessed this scope of kindness in people. The OC4 adventure has been very kind to me personally. It has given me a second family and lifelong best friends. It is often easy to forget the thank yous and the appreciations once you get too close to the members. So today, I thank all my OC4 family for the exceptional, inspirational, outstanding work put into making OC4 an unforgettable event. Participants, you are in for a ride today. Enjoy it and good luck.
We're very pleased that AUB Provost Professor Muhammad Harajli is with us today to launch the fourth International Organic Chemistry Competition, OC4. I call on Provost Harajli to address the audience.
It's a pleasure to be addressing young students and the bright, particularly in chemistry. Contestants, colleagues, distinguished guests, and esteemed visitors. AUB is honored to host the 2016 Organic Chemistry Competition, referred to as OC4, an event that highlights the talent, enthusiasm, and teamwork of students and educators alike. We appreciate the patronage and the presence with us today of His Excellency Roni Araiji, the Lebanese Minister of Culture, and Dr. Zahida Darwish Jabbour, the Secretary General of the Lebanese Commission for UNESCO. We welcome our guests from other Lebanese universities and from around the world. This year, 123 teams from 17 universities in 7 countries will participate. We are delighted to have teams with us today from across Lebanon, as well as Russia, Bulgaria, Turkey, Serbia, Iran, and Jordan. This year's competition also marks the 150th anniversary of AUB, a special occasion for all of us, and a reminder of the longevity of AUB's commitment to liberal arts education, of which this competition is an excellent example. The organic chemistry competition infuses mastery of a subject with excitement, motivating students as active learners through its innovative use of classroom technologies. In addition, it emphasizes teamwork so that students learn to collaborate, a key skill that will serve them the rest of their lives. Finally, competitors engage with students from all over the world, broadening their horizons. This competition is the initiative of Dr. Bilal Kaafarani from the Department of Chemistry, as you all know. He is an educator with tireless enthusiasm. For his students, and it is that enthusiasm which makes it no surprise that he won this year the AUB, what we call the AUB Teaching Excellence Award. I want to congratulate him and the Department of Chemistry on this honor and thank him for his work on this competition. We also must thank the OC4 team, 40 dedicated students from almost all AUB's faculties and schools, whose hard work and the creativity have made this exciting event possible today. Best of luck to the students' team and enjoy the competition.
Thank you, Provost Harajli. For the fourth competition in a row, we are organizing our organic competition under the patronage of the Lebanese National Commission for UNESCO. I call on Dr. Zahida Darwish, the Secretary General for the Lebanese National Commission for UNESCO, to come to the podium.
صاحب الرعاية معالي الوزير الأستاذ ريمون عريجي حضرة نائب رئيس الجامعة للشؤون الأكاديمية بروفيسور محمد حراجلي حضرة عميد كلية العلوم في الجامعة الأمريكية دين باتريك ماجريفي الطلاب الهيئة الأكاديمية الطلاب الأعزاء يسرني أن أكون اليوم معكم في هذا اللقاء الذي أصبح موعداً سنوياً لمباريات في الكيمياء العضوية يشترك فيها نخبة من الطلاب الذين يتابعون تخصصهم الجامعي في مجال الكيمياء هذا العلم الذي لطالما اعتبر فن إحداث التحولات من خلال معادلات وتراكيب تجمع بين مكونات مختلفة وفق معايير محددة ومدروسة ووفق شروط واضحة فينتج عن العملية مكون جديد وقديما ساد الاعتقاد بأن علم الكيمياء يشتمل على سر تحويل المعدن إلى ذهب لذلك يمكنني القول لكم أيها الطلاب الأعزاء أنكم تتمتعون عن طريق العلم والمعرفة المقترنة بالحكمة بالقدرة على إحداث تحولات إيجابية في محيطكم ومجتمعاتكم فتصبح السلبيات مادة خام تعالجونها بما يتوفر لكم من رؤى وأفكار نيرة فتستحيلوا إلى أداة تغيير نحو الأفضل خاصة إذا تضافرت الجهود وتنوعت الرؤى وها أنتم اليوم في الجامعة الأمريكية الأمينة لدورها الجامع للعلوم والمعارف المختلفة بل للشرائح الاجتماعية والجماعات والجنسيات المختلفة ها أنتم تجتمعون لتتباروا بروح رياضية وقد جئتم من الجامعات اللبنانية ومن المنطقة العربية ومن أوروبا تأكيداً على دور العلم في صنع حضارة إنسانية واحدة إننا في اللجنة الوطنية اللبنانية لليونسكو إذ نستلهم القيم الأخلاقية والإنسانية التي قام عليها لبنان كما القيم والأهداف التي تسعى إلى إرسائها وتحقيقها منظمة اليونسكو نؤكد على الدور الذي تلعبه العلوم في النهوض بالمجتمعات لكننا نؤمن كذلك بأن التقدم العلمي لابد أن يقترن بتقدم في مجال العلوم الإنسانية فيتكامل معها بحيث يبقى الإنسان الهدف الأساسي والقيمة الأولى. وهذا ما أدركته الجامعة الأمريكية برئاسة البروفيسور فضل الخوري الذي أطلق مبادرة لتشجيع الطلاب على دراسة الآداب والعلوم الإنسانية والاجتماعية من خلال منح مدرسية جامعية خصصت لذلك. إن التطور العلمي والتكنولوجي قد ينقلب من نعمة إلى نقمة إن لم يواكبه بناء العقل والتفكير النقدي والثقافة بروافدها المختلفة، وإن لم يتم إخضاعه لضوابط ومعايير أخلاقية. من هنا أنشئت في منظمة اليونسكو لجنة دولية متخصصة لأخلاقيات البيولوجيا، ولبنان ممثل فيها، كما تشكلت لجنة وطنية لبنانية لأخلاقيات البيولوجيا. وفي هذا السياق بادرت اللجنة الوطنية لليونسكو بالتعاون مع المجلس الوطني للبحوث العلمية إلى بلورة شرعة لأخلاقيات البحث العلمي سيصار إلى اعتمادها على المستوى الإقليمي. أخيراً يطيب لي أن أشير إلى ارتفاع نسبة إقبال الفتيات في لبنان والعالم العربي على دراسة العلوم وعلى تنفيذ الأبحاث العلمية، وقد يكون ذلك من الأسباب التي دفعت شركة لوريال إلى تخصيص جائزة لوريال يونسكو التي تمنح كل سنة للباحثات في العالم العربي. وقد فازت بهذه الجائزة سيدتان تحملان الدكتوراه من الجامعة الأمريكية. ولا يسعني في الختام إلا أن أتمنى الفوز للمتباريات والمتبارين، علماً أنكم كلكم فائزون بمجرد مشاركتكم في هذا النشاط، متمنية للطلاب الضيوف إقامة ممتعة في لبنان، ومعتذرة منهم لأنني أتكلم بالعربية وليس بلغة أجنبية، علماً أن لغتي الأجنبية هي اللغة الفرنسية وليس الإنجليزية. ولن يفوتني أن أتوجه بالشكر للدكتور بلال قعفراني المتميز بجهوده ونشاطه والذي أصبح صديقاً نعتز به للجنة الوطنية. وشكراً.
Thank you, Dr. Darwish, for the kind words. Today's event, and for the first time, is also organized under the patronage of the Lebanese Ministry of Culture. We are very grateful to His Excellency, Mr. Roni Araiji, the Lebanese Minister of Culture, for being with us despite his very, very, very busy schedule. I invite His Excellency, Mr. Roni Araiji, to address the audience.
مرحبا. رح احكي بالعربي بس بعرف انه في بيناتكم اجانب، بس تنشدد على اهمية اللغة العربية. العمداء الكرام، الدكتورة زهيدة درويش الأمينة العامة للجنة الوطنية لليونسكو، الأساتذة الأكاديميين، الطلاب الأعزاء، السيدات والسادة. اول شيء بحب اقول لكم انه مفارقة عجيبة، كنت أنا بالترمينال نول بالشيمي، نول. اليوم بعد ما بعرف 25-30 سنة أرجع أرعى مسابقة للكيمياء فيها مفارقة عكل حال. يسعدني مشاركتكم في افتتاح مباراة في الكيمياء للسنة الرابعة على التوالي بهدف اكتساب المفاهيم الأساسية في الكيمياء العضوية وبأجواء من التنافس الرياضي المرح ظاهر. إن مشاركة طلاب من جامعات لبنانية ومن منطقة الشرق الأوسط وأبعد دلالة رمزية على المستوى العالي لهذه المباراة التي تقام بدعم من اليونسكو، من اللجنة الوطنية والاتحاد العالمي للكيمياء الطبيعية والتطبيقية. تتزامن هذه المباراة مع الذكرى 150 لتأسيس الجامعة الأمريكية في بيروت. هذه الجامعة لعبت ولا تزال دوراً محورياً في التعليم، وشكلت صرحاً معرفياً عبر تخريج قامات في مجالات القيادة الفكرية والسياسية والأدبية والعلمية، واحتلت مواقع الصدارة في لبنان والعالم العربي والعالم. إن المسابقة التي تقيمون اليوم بحضور طلاب من غير جامعة عربية وأجنبية تندرج في ضمن سياق نشر العلوم التي دأبت الجامعة الأمريكية عليه في لبنان والعالم، بغية الإسهام بتكوين مجتمعات تبنى على أسس المعرفة والتخصص سمة التطور البشري. إن ميزة هذا الصرح العريق انتهاجه استراتيجية دأب على تنفيذها منذ تأسيسه، توائم بين المنح الأكاديمي التخصصي وبين فتح شبابيك المعرفة على المدى الأرحب. فلم يعد الهدف على المدى الحصري منح شهادات التخصص، بل تعداه إلى معرفة الإنسان وأفاق الحياة وإسراء المسار الثقافي في لبنان والعالم العربي. قد تتساءلون ماذا يفعل وزير الثقافة هنا ويرعى احتفالاً علمياً؟ أقول لكم أنه من الرائع والمفيد والعصري اهتمامكم بالشأن العلمي ومحاكاة تطور العصر، غير أن اقتصار البحث في قضايا العلم يبقى قاصراً عن تطور إنسانيتنا. فاللغات أيضاً حاجة أساسية وضرورية للتواصل والإبداع بين الشعوب وتلاقي الحضارات، كما أن تنمية ثقافتنا على تنوعها تسري وجودنا وتفتح آفاقاً وتعزز إنسانيتنا وعقولنا وقبولنا لمن هم مختلفون عنا ولما هو مختلف عن ما لدينا. تعلمون ولا شك بأن لبنان كان بين الدول المؤسسة لقيام منظمة اليونسكو سنة 1946 إيماناً بدور الثقافة والعلوم في تطوير المجتمعات البشرية. وقد جاء في ميثاق اليونسكو: لما كانت الحروب تولد في عقول البشر ففي عقولهم يجب أن تبنى حصون السلام. ما أحوجنا اليوم إلى استنهاض قيم التنوير والثقافة والانفتاح لصد موجات التطرف والجريمة وحروب الإلغاء، وخاصة في منطقة الشرق الأوسط. في الختام، تحية لإدارة الجامعة الأمريكية ولقسم الكيمياء والدكتور كعفراني بشكل خاص، ولكل من ساهم في تنظيم هذا التباري الحضاري. كل التهاني للطلاب المشاركين والذين سيفوزون، وشكراً وعاش لبنان.
Thank you, Your Excellency. I'm very grateful to the sponsors of our event. I would like to sincerely acknowledge SciFinder scholar Wiley, Oxford University Press, the Lebanese National Council for Scientific Research, CNRS, France Bank, Beit Misk, Tainol, VTC Acros, Ibra Haddad, Alphamad VWR, Biotechno, Johnson & Johnson, AUBMC, USFC, and Lancaster Hotels and Suites, where all the international participants are staying. I am also very thankful to the AUB COO's office and to Mr. Andrew Vickens for the financial support. Now I'm going to go over the rules of the competition and then we will start. All the contestants will be competing simultaneously. The teams will be competing using clickers that are programmed to take only one response, to answer multiple choice questions with 4 to 8 possible choices. I will present each question and will allow students some time to enter their answers. When all responses are collected, as indicated by the software on the slide, you will be able to see that, the statistics of students' answers are shown on the slide. Then I will briefly explain the question. We have many audience, they don't know as much about organic chemistry, so I'll be very, very brief. And then I will give the correct answer. The competition consists of two rounds. In the first round, there are 10 questions. All teams that answer correctly will get 10 points for each correct question. So speed is not a factor here. Then we have round two. To qualify for round two, students should have answered at least five out of 10 questions correctly in round one. Each correct answer in round two will also get 10 points. But the fastest five teams that answer correctly will receive additional points as follows. The first team will get 10 bonus points. The second team will get 8 bonus points. The third will get 6 bonus points. The fourth will get 4 bonus points. And the fifth team gets 2 bonus points. So eventually, a team may win the entire competition even if the team number does not show up on the slide. The points from round one are rolled to round two. In case of a tie at the end of the second round, a sudden death round will decide the winners. At the end of the session, the top four teams with the largest number of points will be awarded. I am very thankful to Professor Samih Isber, Professor Wasim Al-Haj, Professor Brigitte Vax. Well, there are many teams from LEU, that's why they are cheering for her. And from the ACPS unit, Mr. Wissam Nahas, Mr. Anis Jiradi, and Ms. Tamara Buzaineddin, who will be taking care of the scores. Thanks to the outstanding efforts of Joseph Azar, Nidal Mawas, Edward Zakaria, and Saeed Shaya, this event is now live streamed on YouTube. We will start now round one. Here we go. Round one. First question. So first I am posting the question and you cannot enter your answers. When I say the point is open, then you can enter your answers. Which is the product of the following reaction? The poll is not open yet. And remember, there are no points for quick answers now. The poll is open now. And on this grid, you will be able to see which teams are answering. عليك بدك كليكر نعطيك كليكر للجواب Okay, can you please enter your answers? Okay, in 3 seconds, I'm gonna close the poll. And here is a clock. Click over there. 3, 2, 1. Poll is closed. Statistics. 40% answered one, which is the wrong answer. 11% answered two, which is also the wrong answer. Correct answer is 3. You have first Birch reduction, so you will get non-conjugated diene. Then you have allylic bromination. Then you have SN1. I know that His Excellency and Dr. Darwish, they have to leave right now. They have other obligations. Thank you very much for coming. Okay. And then we have an SN1 reaction. Now let's carry on. Second question. Which is the product of the following reaction? And the poll is open. Team number one answered. Okay, I'm going to close the poll. Please enter your answers. In 3 seconds, I'm going to close the poll. Poll is closed. Statistics. 53% answered correctly. That's just the hydrolysis of an acetal. And since you have the O18, it's going to be in the carbonyl. Okay, next question. What is R, the products of the following reaction? And the poll is open now. It's not open, guys. Now it's open. Remember, the clicker is taking only one answer, the first answer. Dr. Tuma, do you need a clicker? Okay, please enter your answers. I'm gonna close the poll in 3 seconds. Poll is closed. No, not yet. 3 seconds to closing the poll. Some teams are not answering. And poll is closed. Statistics. The correct answer is 7. This is an SN1. You have an allylic carbocation. You look at the resonance structure. You are going to get the front attack and the backside attack. 4 products. Question 4, which is the product of the following reaction? And the poll is open now. Okay, please, guys, enter your answers. I'm gonna click on the clock. Remember, as soon as I click, 3 seconds, and it will be automatically closed. The poll will be closed in 3 seconds. And it's closed. Statistics. Rainbow. Correct answer is 2. You're having an SN2 reaction, so it will be inversion. It's going to go to the less substituted carbon. You have O minus, it will be deuterated, converted into OTS, and then you're doing a reduction. Next question. Which is the product of the following reaction? And the poll is up. Please enter your answers. I'm gonna close the poll in 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Poll is closed. Statistics. 44% answered wrongly. 30% answered wrongly. Correct answer is 3. A nucleophilic addition, and you'll get an aromatic compound. Next question. What is the relationship between the following compounds? Yeah. Take your time. The typical question in chemistry 211. Careful, guys, the hydrogen's in the plane. And the poll is open. This is question 6. 4 more questions in round 1. Can you please enter your answers?
I'm going to close the poll in 3 seconds. I'm going to click on it now. So enter your answers. 3, 2, 1. Poll is closed. Statistics. Nice. 72% answer correctly. Yeah, they're stable. Good job. Question 7. Which is the product of the following reaction? The poll is open. Nobody has answered yet. There are only 8 conditions. Team 1, 12, 42, 43. Please enter your answers. I'm going to close the poll in 3 seconds. And the clock is on. Poll is closed. Statistics. Yeah, 77% get it out. Okay, so you have free the Kraft's alkylation, then nitration, then you're reducing, then diazonium salt, then you're forming phenol, then you're forming phenoxide, then a Suntory reaction, then Claisen rearrangement. Correct answer is 2. Next question. Question 8. Which is the product of the following reaction? This is one of my favorite questions. I have many of them, but they are more in round 2. This is one of them. What is the product of the following reaction? And the poll is open. Please enter your answers. I'm gonna close the poll in 3 seconds. And the clock is on. 3, 2, 1. Close. Statistics. 48% answer correct. So you're having enolate, and then you're having Michael addition, and then you're having saponification, protonation, decarboxylation. You only can decarboxylate the CO2 that is beta. So the correct answer is 4. Question 9, 2 more questions in round 1. What is the degree of hydrogen deficiency for the product of the following reaction sequence? Hello, Heather. Not my favorite question, but I liked it. And the poll is open. Can you please enter your answers? I'm gonna close the poll in 3 seconds. Whoa. And the correct answer is 5. So you're having radical chlorination, then elimination, and E2 reaction. Then you are going to form the cis diol, and then you're having acetal. The degree of unsaturation is going to be 5. You already have here 1, 2, 3, and then there is a ring and another ring, so it will be 5. Last question in round 1. Which is the product of the following reaction? And the poll is open. You know, after round 2 and after we announce the awards, we have a very rich buffet outside. So the faster we finish, the earlier we eat. Please enter your answers. I'm gonna click on the clock. In 3 seconds, I will be closing the poll. 3, 2, 1. Poll is closed. statistics, correct answer is one. This will conclude round one.
The OC4 team has voted to grant the picture of Sujita Bios Karma and Moniz Bios Karma. They voted to grant these two young gentlemen the $200 monetary cash award for the hashtag OC4 campaign. The OC4 team. The OC4 team will make sure that the $200 will reach these two young minds. Now we will announce the qualifying teams to round two.
Qualifying teams to round two. Team number one. Team number two. Team number 11. Team number 12 from Novosibirsk State University from Russia. Team number 15, team number 16 from Sofia University. Team number 17, team number 21, team number 24, team number 27 from LEU. Team number 30, team number 31, team number 34, LEU. Team number 36, team number 39, team number 40, team number 41, team number 42. Team number 42 is from Turkey, team number 44 from Serbia. Team number 45, LEU again. Team number 54, AUB 55, AUB 56, AUB 58, AUB 64. 64 is AUB, LEU. One is from AUB, the other one from LEU. Team number 66, team number 69 from the Lebanese University. Team number 70, team number 72, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 85, 87, 88, 101, 105, 113, AUB and Beirut Arab University. 116, 117, 118, USG. And the last qualifying team is from Jordan. From Jordan University Science and Technology, team number 123. OC4 team, collect the clickers for non-qualifying teams. We will get ready to round two. Round two, we have 8 questions. Every correct question will get 10 points. So you don't need to be on the fastest 5 teams. And then the fastest 5 teams, they get additional points. Okay, again, I'm gonna display the question. I'll give you some time. And then I'll open the poll. Sometimes I may open it fast, sometimes I'll open it slow. It depends on the question. Okay, round two, first question. What is the chemical structure of B in the following reaction? So you have these two starting material reacting. You have carbon dioxide plus B. What is B? And the poll is open. Good. Take your time. There will be a video after round two so that we will see who are the winners. And video three is the best video, actually. So wait for video three. So it's good. So you can see the new scoring system has greatly improved since the first competition. And you can see right now that people are taking their time, not just answering randomly, just to be on the top five teams. So I like the outcome. Okay, can you please enter your answers now? Okay, in 3 seconds I'm gonna close the poll. How many teams did we get to qualify for round two? 44 teams. Okay, in 3 seconds I'm closing the poll. Please, in 3 seconds I'm closing the poll. Whoa. Correct answer is 5. You have a deals holder reaction and then you have a retro deals holder reaction. Team number 123, they get 10 points. Team number 42, they get 8 points. Team number 30, they get 6 points. Team number 72, they get 4 points. And team number 76 gets 2 points. Team number 123 is from Jordan University of Science and Technology. Team number 42 is from Middle East Technical University. Team number 30 is from AUB. Team number 72 is from AUB. Team number 76 is also from AUB. Next question. That's my favorite question. What is compound A that upon osmolysis leads to products B to F? Upon catalytic hydrogenation, A is transformed into 4-cyclopentyl, 3-5-7, trimethyl, no name. And the poll is open. Okay, please enter your answers. I'm gonna close the poll in 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Poll is closed. Statistics. 52% answered. قلت له قبل ما اقول كانه correctly ولا لا correct correct answer is 3. The fastest teams team number 80. So may you be team 101 is from the Lebanese University. Team number 16 from Sofia University. Team number 17 is from AUB. Team number 123 from Jordan University of Science and Technology. Good job, guys. Next. Which is are the major products of the following reaction? And the poll is open. Can you please enter your answers? I'm going to close the poll in 3 seconds. Poll is closed. Statistics, 52% answer correctly. This is an E2 reaction, but careful. This is in the Fisher projection. You have stereoelectronic effect. You need to rotate so that you have the BR and the hydrogen anti-and periplanar. That will lead to 1 as the correct answer. The fastest 5 teams. Team number 42 from Middle East Technical University. Good job, guys. Team number 11 from AUB. Team number 16 from Sofia University, Bulgaria. Bravo. Team number 123 from Jordan University of Science and Technology. Good job, guys. Team number 1 from AUB. Next question. Which is the expected product of the following reaction sequence? And the poll is open. Please enter your answers. I'm going to close the poll in 3 seconds. And the clock is on. Poll is closed. Statistics, 48% answer correctly. You're forming acid chloride, then amide, you're reducing, then you form the ammonium salt. You do the ion exchange, Hoffman elimination, which is anti-Zaitsev. So correct answer is 3. Fastest 5 teams. Team number 12 from Novosibirsk State University, Russia. Team number 42 from Middle East Technical University. Team number 24 from AUB. Team number 123 from Jordan University of Science and Technology. Team number 39 from AUB. Next. Now that is my favorite question. And Paul is open. Can you please enter your answers? I'm gonna close the poll in 3 seconds. Poll is closed. Statistics. Well, you're having a radical chlorination. And you have 3 types of allylic hydrogens. And then they have resonance structures. The correct answer is 6. All of these are correct. Correct answer is 6. I spent 2 hours designing this question. The top, the fastest 5 teams, team number 54 from AUB, team number 101 from the Lebanese University, Gohsen. Team number 12 from Novosibirsk State University, team number 15 from AUB, team number 42 from Middle East Technical University. Next question. The Robinson annulation of D and E yields F. What is the structure of F? Poll is open. Two more questions, and then we have the winners. Well, actually, there is a video before. Can you please enter your answers? I'm gonna close the poll in 3 seconds. And here is the clock. Poll is closed. Statistics. 28% answered 1, which is the wrong answer. 28% answered 2, which is also the wrong answer. 6% answered 3, which is also the wrong answer. 8% answered 4, which is the wrong answer. 5 is the correct answer. Fastest 5 teams. Team number 70. From LAU, team number 21 from AUB, team number 16 from Sofia University, team number 44 from University of Novi Sad, and team number 45 from LAU. Question 17, 2 more questions. What is the product of this reaction sequence? Only 10 conditions. Poll is not open yet. The poll is open. Please enter your answers. One more question. Please enter your answers. The food is already set outside. Enter your answers. In 3 seconds, I'm going to close the poll. 3, 2, 1, poll is closed. Statistics. 45% answered wrongly. 25% answered wrongly. And one of the 15% answered wrongly. Correct answer is 1. You're having lytic reaction, bromination, and then you are having the alkanilid, you protonate, you get the alkyne, terminal alkyne. Radical bromination, it's gonna go anti-Markovnikov. Then you are gonna form the Grignard, you attack cyclohexanone, you protonate. You eliminate, you will get diene, you do a Diels-Alder reaction, and then you reduce. The fastest 5 teams. Team number 113. It's an AUB BAU team. Team number 55 from AUB. Team number 12 from Novosibirsk State University, Russia. Team number 87 from LAU. Team number 24 from AUB. The last question in this competition, unless we have sudden death. I don't think we will have sudden death, but let's see. Last question. Now that is the favorite question. What is the structure of a compound, C9H7F3, whose proton NMR is shown? And the poll is open. Please enter your answers. I'm going to close the poll in 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Poll is closed. We have 44 teams that qualified. Statistics, 34% answered wrongly. Well, you have doublet, another doublet, doublet of doublet. This is the stereotopic hydrogen. Definitely not this one, and not this one. So 14% are wrong. Now, look how many signals do we have here. And we have this broad singlet. The correct answer is 2. The fastest 5 teams. This is a meta. Team number 55 from AUB. Team number 41 from AUB, team number 117 from the Lebanese University, team number 113, AUB, BAU, team number 31 from LAU.
I kindly ask all the members of the OC4 team who are currently present in the hall to stand up. I have been very fortunate to work with such a group of exceptional, incredible, creative, and enthusiastic students who have continued to astonish me every day with their groundbreaking ideas. I just can't thank you enough for making my job a beautiful one. I am indebted to all of you. You make teaching exciting and rewarding. You inspire me every day. Please join me in giving them a big round of applause for their superb work. Thank you. Please be seated. We have the results.
So, we need a sudden death round. The fourth award goes to Abdurrahman Al-Qutb and Hussein Khalifi from LEU. The third award, the fourth award is $300 cash. The third award, $500 cash, goes to Edgar Makarov and Bodgen Rodin from Novosibirsk State University, Russia. And up. LEU team, can you please stand up? Take a picture of them right there. Please be seated. Please be seated. And the sudden death round is between Svetlin Aliyev and Pavel Kostadinov from Sofia University, Bulgaria. Please stand up. And Tughrul Almamadov and Tolga Yaman from Middle East Technical University. Please be seated. We are going to do the sudden death round first, and then we will give the award. Dean McGreevy will talk, and then sudden death round. Okay, so now only these two teams are to answer. So we're talking about team 16 and 42. Nobody else is to answer, only these two teams. Please, lights, dim lights. Sudden death round. The first question. I have a series of sudden death questions. Hopefully we will finish it with the first question. And I'm gonna open the poll right away. Okay, I'm warning you. Pardon? This, of course. Now whoever wins right now, we are gonna see the fastest teams. Whoever, and we're gonna announce it right on the spot. Okay? Which is the product of the following reaction? Poll is open. Nobody has answered yet. Put the, here we go. Okay, so one of the teams answered. The second team, take your time now. Take your time, because it doesn't matter if they answer correctly. If they answer correctly, well, you're going to be second. If they answered wrongly, it's your chance to get it right. Okay? So the team that answered is the team from Bulgaria. Okay, now you have to answer, okay? We need to eat. And Dean McGreevy has a meeting. He's waiting. I promised him we will be done right now, and we're not done. Sorry, Dean McGreevy. Okay. So, please click here. And we have one of the teams to answer correctly. The correct answer is 4. Team number 42, they win the first prize. Very good. Please be seated. Dean McGreevy.
On behalf of the Faculty of Arts and Sciences, I just wanted to congratulate everyone who participated in this event. I think it was very fruitful for everybody involved. And congratulations particularly to the winners.
Okay, we're going to start with the fourth award. So they are writing the names on the checks. We're going to have huge checks right here. So we'll, can you help them? They are just writing the names on the checks. In 5 minutes, we'll be done. Then we are going to cut the cake. And then there is a very, very generous buffet catered by AUBMC cafeteria waiting for us outside. So you can eat for 2 days outside. I'm going to call on the team from LEU to come first. Please come down. And we take a picture with them. Please, right here. Hussein Khalifi, here you go. And Abdul Rahman, here you go. Okay, can you please face it right there? Thank you. Now Edgar. Yeah, okay, 500. Yeah, please remain over there, stay with him. Yeah, team number, the third award, come on over here. The team from Russia. Yes, right here, this is your check. Bogdan and Edgar, okay. Here we go. Here we go. Thank you. Please stand right here. So the second prize, Bulgarian team, $1,000. So Pavel, here you go. And Svetlana, here you go. Thank you. And the first award goes to the team from Middle East Technical University. Can you get this? Here you go. Please come over here. This is for you. And this is for you. Give me the second one. Togrul? Togrul, that's you. And this is for you. Well, put it like this. Okay? And we take the picture. Now everybody come. Bring here. Yeah. Arbulhon. Yeah, take one group picture. Everybody. Here we go. Now, bring the cake. Let's cut the cake. OC4 team, join me here. We just cut the cake and then we start eating. And then the party in the evening. Yalla, bring it.
We need to give it to
Yeah. Okay, right now, just put it here. Okay.